Speaking of great stuff, we started this morning with a man who has a great series of names to drop. Carson Daly is going to spend New Year's Eve with Lenny Kravitz and Alicia Keys. We'll talk about that big New Year's show in a moment, and also a chance to talk live with Carson now on TV about what he and I talked about on the phone, his return to his late night show and the decidedly mixed emotions surrounding that return. We're going to press a button, and he's wearing actually a very nice tie. Let's see. There he is. Wow. Indeed, a nice tie. He popped right up. Hey, thank Carson, you, good morning.
Good morning, Sam. How are you?
Good. Thank how are you?
You like this, huh?
I do like it.
Very good.
I got to ask you one other thing. All morning we've been eavesdropping on you. You have been fiddling with something. Is it a little BlackBerry or something?
You've had down here?
Yeah. Below.
No.
No?
Oh, no. Oh. No, my nails and my bracelet. I've been thinking about taking this off, but
there.
I've been kind of playing with it down here. Is that what you mean?
I guess so.
We don't
want to
know.
That's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
We were hoping it was a BlackBerry.
Yeah. Carson, let's talk about
is
it.
Is that what the kids call it?
Yeah. You and I had a nice conversation about it on the phone, and it was about your feeling that you thought essentially your return to the show was being misinterpreted. Now, obviously, you're back doing a Last Call. Jay Leno and Conan O'Brien come back to the air next week. You tell me, how do you feel about it now? Does their return make you feel better? Is that the right adjective?
No. Nothing, no. And I don't want to spend a lot of time talking about the strike, but I do appreciate our conversation that we had. No, it doesn't. I mean, it's a terrible situation, the strike, and there's really nothing. Scott Collins wrote an article in the LA Times that came out on Monday that I think had the most factual information about sort of my stance and where I, how I felt I needed to come back for one reason, just to save the jobs of 75 people, and that was it. So I would sort of point people in that direction for my thoughts on it. But no, I mean, it's just a bad situation. Nobody's happy about coming back to work. The shows all sort of suffer because of it, obviously, and it's just not fun.
Not to dwell on it, but one last quick thing. Your program and the other shows that are back, do you find, you get a lot of music guests and people who are obviously detached from this whole thing, but just the regular, typical celebrity who would normally come by, are they coming by?
Well, our show's different because we're half an hour, and you're right. We're primarily an interview show. We've done a lot more interviews. I anticipate most of the shows will. And guests are tough. It'll be interesting to see who has who on the second when the shows come back. We do a lot of stuff. I talk to the musicians. A lot of other shows don't really tend to do that. I put a lot of new artists on. I put a lot of up-and-coming young Hollywood actors, people like that. So I think I have a chance to fill a less amount of time on the air, so it's a little bit easier for me to do. But, yeah, I mean, some actors, don't feel comfortable doing the shows, but I'm sure all of that will, we'll see. The second will be a big day for all that.
What happens on the 31st Monday night in New York City? Not newcomers, really. Alicia Keys and Lenny Kravitz. That's exciting.
Yeah, it's awesome. I remember my first New Year's was with MTV, I think in 97 or 98 in Times Square. They just bought that big, TRL building with the glass, and I remember being there, and if Eminem or Britney or somebody big came on TRL, we were, used to sort of standing above 1,000 or 2,000 people, but that first New Year's where there was, 750,000 or 1 million people in that four-block radius that is Times Square, I mean, it was such an awesome sight. So I've grown very accustomed to hosting New Year's Eve and have done it. This is our fourth year now at NBC, and it's incredible. And we try and put, I think, a lot of that excitement in Times Square into people's living rooms. We don't like to break away from New York that much. And we have Lenny Kravitz performing live in Times Square and Alicia Keys on a rooftop over Fifth Ave, and it's a lot of fun to do, and I think we have a really good show this year.
Now, Tuesday morning, will Ryan Seacrest text you his ratings and sort of do a comparison thing?
No, he won't. I'll probably see him. We usually text each other. I spoke to him, I think, last week. We were starting to, how you doing over there? Are you gearing up? And we'll speak probably here in a couple of days, and we always try and get together and have a beer or something after the show. So I'll probably see him. But no, there won't be any ratings. He's also on the air for like 9 hours, so I won't have a chance.
What do you do after the show? Do you guys actually go and celebrate New Year's, or is it kind of like, okay, I'm done, I'm spent, time to go home?
Yeah.
Well, that's during the show, but I mean after the, no.
It's funny, at MTV, there were no rules at MTV. It was like the inmates running the prison when I worked there. I mean, you really could. It was just like, no parents, you know, and we drank on the air, and that's what MTV really is all about, is sort of that rock and roll lifestyle. And, you know, obviously we were responsible, but it was a lot more liberal. I mean, NBC, you feel happy to have the gig, and you don't want to blow it. So, you know, I sort of play by the rules. That's a long day of doing press and getting ready, and then you do the show, and it's just all adrenaline. And then the minute the ball drops, and the minute you're off the air at 12:35, you get to the first bottle of alcohol that you can find, and you take care of it. You just chug it all.
You know what, Carson? My friendly suggestion to you is hold up what appears to be a water bottle, but I think Everclear inside. I think that's the way to go. Not now.
Where?
When you're doing the show.
Oh, damn, that's so... what I was about to say. Yes.
Clearly
yes,
you need your writer's
already
pack.
Done. You just
all right.
Take off the label.
There we go. There's Carson Daly live in New
happy
York City.
New
Happy New Year to Carson Daly. Thanks very much for that. You know what? I mean, that was nice to talk to him. I think he's still very troubled. I mean, honestly, about the
I'm
other
sure,
thing.
It is.
Yeah.
You know,
sure.
it's a tough decision to make, and I just feel like as these people are coming back and that kind of stuff, you're crumbling the walls. You know, it's like, hey, you know, writers, I really feel you're on your own.
Well,
believe me, when it comes to all of a sudden the actors and that, it's going to affect me? No.
Well,
and it's a tough situation because he wants to come on to talk about this New Year's Eve event, but the fact is top of mind right now for everybody is the writer's strike, and we have to ask him.
And you know, the other thing that's going to be very, very interesting, because it's a very good point, and I guess this will be New Year's Eve is Monday night, so Tuesday night when these late night shows come back, who is that guest?
Yeah,
and is it
curious.
Jack Hanna with Chimps, which is what I assume it will be?
Or all these people like our gadget guys,
right.
Muscle Man of Technology, the guy was doing the manor section with Gail.
Right.
All these guys are going to be.